Okay, so remember, so we are going to handle now the type of the yeast that are called non-exact, of course, their first order. Now, this type of equation sometimes are called linear ordinary differential equations. If you don't, they don't call it non-exact, they call them linear, and this is the type of this form. So, now these ones are not exact because it's hard to see what the differential is really. So what we do, we assume that R will be an equating factor, that if you multiply it through by this R, now that equation is going to be exact. So, you said if I multiply it through by R here, I get this R and float. So I assume now this is exact, because I assume that if you multiply it through by R, it becomes exact. Where P, Q and R, all those are functions of X. Now, if it's exact, I assume if I get R and Y, I differentiate them by fix R, differentiate Y, then plus fix Y, differentiate R. Now, after doing this, I compare this and this, so we compare. So this will be the same as this. Now, the coefficient of Y here is R and P, and the coefficient of Y here is the R, the X, like this. So now, here, what I do is separate the variables, I take R this side, I separate. Then after doing that, I integrate this to get the natural log of that. Then that will keep it because we always need this P. Then the natural log is the same as log base P. So if I take this beside this with the properties of logarithms, I have this. And now, this is how we get the integrating factor that is going to make every of this type exact. But now after getting this R, all you do, you get R times Y equaling to R times Q. Where is Q? Q is this function here, because the log of this is equaling to Q. So we already get Q times R, we equal to R times Y, then we separate the variables. Now, the other fact is, when you have exponent of natural log of a function, it's equaling to that function. Meaning, if I have a natural log of 2, it's always equaling to 2, this function here. It's a property of logarithms. Now, from here you see that now we compare. If I compare now with the y, the x plus b, y equaling to q, it's always in this format. So now we compare if this coefficient is 1. So this is 1 and this is another way we compare. If you compare now, so your p is 2 and your q is 4. So mean that now I need to get the integrating factor using this formula. So now my r, which is e integral of p dx, which will be e, now integral my p is 2 dx, and integrate this, we get e. When integrate 2, we get 2x. From there, so my R is this. After doing that, what you do, you come and say, now this one is going to make it a question. I multiply it out, I'm here now E, 2x, dy, dx, then plus 2e, 2x, y, equaling 4e, 2x. Now this one is exact. What you do, you get D, dx, you get your R, which is this, E, 2x, then times your y equaling to what is this side. You say you get q times r, q times r, that's why you get our q times our r, 4e2r. Then you separate the variables, you say that you have d of y e2x equaling to 4e2x dx. And interpret this. So what we have here is y e2x equaling to 2 exponent 2x plus c. When you integrate this together, half more price there, it is like this. We have this condition, when x is 0, we have 0 times this, so we have 5 times, when I put here 0, it's 1 times 1 equaling to, now when I put here the 0 here in the power 0, which is 1 times 2 plus c, that my c is a 3. Writing it back, half y e2x equaling to 2e2x now plus 3. This one is called a particular. When I come to this, now before you compare, I said the coefficient is not 1. Always have coefficient of this
coefficients will be 1, this differential coefficient should be 1.
So to make it 1, I divide by x. Divide by x, I have by x here, by x here, by x here. So we add it now. So now there, we can pick our things. Just now here, my p, so your p here, you take it with this sign. It's now the coefficient of y. It's negative 1 over x. And from here, so my q is 2x squared. So from there, now we need to decorate our r. The formula for r is here. R is equal to e integral p dx, which will be now e integral of negative 1 over x dx. When you compare this to x, this will give us our r will be here, e negative, integrate 1 over x will get natural log of x. But then we say this power works, this should be positive 1. So we take this negative, which will be adding down, e natural log of, when I take this negative here, it will be x power negative 1 when I take it here, but this will be 1 over x. So yeah, I have 1 over x. And now we see coefficient 1, this and this, to always give us that function. So that function is this. Start from here, my r is 1 over x. So remember, from there, all I do is now to get this r and I multiply it out here. So you get the real now 1 over x dy dx. Now times y over x squared equaling to 2, now x multiplied by 1 over x there. So now from there, thirdly, you get d dx, you get your r times y. My r is this, then y, 1 over x equaling to this, the q times the r. The q times the r. Multiply this and the our r here, you get 2x is already here. So separate, now we have dy over x equaling to 2x dx. Integrating both sides, so that we have y over x equaling to x squared plus c. This is a general solution. When I add this, now this function is not one side, so I start by dividing by sine. So this will be now dy dx, then plus, if I divide the sine here, you say I have sine x over sine x over sine x. Now, this will give me now hot x then times y equaling to 3 over sine x. From here now we pick that the start my p, the coefficient of y is hot x, while my q will be 3 over sine x. So to get now the integrating factor r, this is the formula, whereas our r is e integral p dx, which will be e integral. Now this time I have cot x dx. When you integrate cot x, what do we get? So my r, when you integrate this, we get e natural log of sine x. When you integrate cot, this is what you get. And see that e of this, using this idea, this will give us just sine x. So my r is sine x. From there, I told you, all you do, you come and get now, here, multiply through my sine, you get now your d of r times y. So you have y times r sine x respect to x equaling to r times q. So this is my q, when I multiply it with r, we see how we are in this. Separating the variables, that my d y sine x is equal to 3 dx. Integrating both sides, y sine x equal to 3x plus c. So now you can put in these conditions and you get this value of c. And please remember, that's how we handle linear differential equations. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. You are going to see more videos. I wish you the best.